I would like to share 5 types of flowers, which are used by our ancestors for living a very healthy life, and can prevent many types of diseases. Please note, information on this video is provided for interest, and information only, and does not constitute any kind of medical advice. At first showing the periwinkle flower plant, known by different name in different places. In our local language it is known as Nayantora. The species has long been cultivated, and used as herbal medicines. During early periods the extracts of its roots, and shoots, though said to be poisonous, is used against several diseases. Periwinkle is somewhat bitter in taste, and can be extremely toxic, if consumed orally by humans without proper knowledge how to consume it, and periwinkle is normally avoided during pregnancy, and breastfeeding. During early period periwinkle was used for treating diabetes, Alzheimer's disease, high blood pressure, malaria, and to enhance memory, which led to its study by Western scientists, who then discovered its anti-cancer properties that could be used in chemotherapy. This pretty flower plant gives us 2 very important cancer-fighting medicines, vinblastine and vincristine. Vinblastine used to help increase the chance of surviving childhood leukemia from 10% to 95%, while vincristine is used to treat Hodgkin's disease. These 2 anti-cancer alkaloids, vinblastine and vincristine, which appear to bind to proteins in some microtubules, facilitating cancer cell death and inhibit the growth of tumors. During our childhood days, I used to remember seeing people consumed around 2 to 3 pieces of leaves of this plant thrice a week, to get rid of high blood pressure, and diabetes. Periwinkle can lower blood pressure. It can also help reduce swelling, and have a drying, astringent, effect, on the tissues. I am showing you the Clitoria ternatea flower, known in English as butterfly pea, and in our local language it is called Aparajita. The flowers are of 2 colors, that is white and blue. The flowers of this vine have the shape of human female genitals, hence the Latin name of the genus Clitoria, from clitoris. The roots of this flower are used traditionally to treat mainly sexual ailments, like infertility, and gonorrhea to control menstrual discharge. The juice of the root of the blue clitoria, if taken with goat milk for 3 days to 1 week period, after menstrual discharge can help in obtaining pregnancy, for women suffering from infertility. The white clitoria roots juice if taken 3 tablespoonfuls twice daily, for 1 week can cure abnormal vaginal discharge, and vaginal infection permanently. The blue clitoria roots juice if inhaled through nose, can cure headache relief from dizziness, or spinning. The seeds of these flowers are used for purgative purposes, treatment of throat diseases, and cough treatment. This plant also improves memory power, ascites, heals leprosy, whooping cough, stomach cramps, eye burns, skin diseases, such as leucoderma pustule, or boils. Many people use to prepare tea with this flower for its color-changing properties, but the health benefits are just as exciting. When steeped, the butterfly pea flower releases antioxidants, much like green tea. Ashoka tree, also known as Saruka indicolin, has many health benefits, and cures ample number of health disorders, and is used as a key ingredient in various therapies, and cures. The Ashoka is the tree most intimately associated with women in India's mythology, and is said to remove a woman's grief, and protector of women's health. The bark of the Ashoka tree is used to make a drug, which is reported to possess a stimulating effect on the endometrium and ovarian tissue. Ashoka tree is an Ayurvedic medicinal plant, and its flowers are eaten raw. The flowers are also sun-dried and eaten to control over urine. The skin, fruit, and flowers are very beneficial to the human body. The skin of this plant is used for treatment of AIDS. The juice of the skin of this plant, if applied, can stop bleeding instantly. The whole tree of night jasmine is used as folk medicines and is believed to be one of the five divine trees that exist in heaven, with numerous medicinal uses. This tree is also known as tree of sorrow because the flowers lose their brightness during daytime, and hence the scientific name Aparajitis, meaning sad tree. This whole plant, including bark of the stem, leaves, flowers, and even its seeds, are used as folk medicines since ancient times. The leaves are used for treating chronic fever, rheumatism, arthritis, joint pain, obstinate sciatica, etc. The leaves juice is bitter in taste and works as a tonic and medicine for treating fever, cough, high blood pressure, and even diabetes. Pluck small amount of leaves, bark, and flower, about 5 grams, and make a decoction with 200 grams of water. Boil it in water in low steam till it reduces to 1/4 of initial quantity. The next morning, strain, stir, and drinking the decoction on an empty stomach is very helpful in reducing pain and inflammation caused due to arthritis. It is also used to cure brain disorders like vertigo and anxiety. Night jasmine is used by many to increase platelets, rebuild them faster, and stops destruction of platelets during dengue and chikungunya. The bark of the stem is boiled in water with dried ginger powder and long pepper for treating malaria. The flowers are used to treat gas formation, astringent to bowel, prevents excess bile secretion by liver, cures cough. The leaf juice is given with honey for treating cough, fever, even malaria, and it arrests loose stools as a result of diarrhea. The leaves are blended into a fine paste and used in treating skin diseases, especially ringworm. It is also used as an antidote for snake bites. The seeds are crushed and the aqueous paste is applied externally for treating piles. The seeds are crushed and boiled in coconut oil in low steams and are also useful in treating baldness, scurvy, and infections of the scalp. The concoction is applied on skins for treating various kind of skin disease. This concoction is a very effective cure for graying of hair, dandruff, baldness, lice, and scalp infections. You are viewing an important medicinal flower plant of Northeast India, but very less documented and evaluated, known by different names but famous as red nongminka, and in our local language known as titubahak. I have seen and heard many people taking this plant leaves orally after boiling it for curing jaundice, coughs, colds, and asthma. It has been used by our ancestors and believed that this plant's flowers, green leaves, and roots act as antidote for pox, anti-diabetic, coughs, colds, anti-asthma, prevent most type of skin diseases, jaundice, rheumatism, analgesic, and antipyretic. The honey extracted from the flowers of these plant during the month of March to May are very bitter in taste, which are used as medicines by our ancestors and used as liver tonic. Thank you. There are some more flowers, which are of huge benefits to the human body, like Nandivitam, and botanical name is Tabanua montana divaricate, which is used to cure various kind of eye diseases. If you like the information on this video, please subscribe for more.